Ontario's wheat crop needs the nitrogen-containing compounds found in fertilizer like this. University of Guelph professor David Hooker at the Ridgetown campus is helping producers determine how to effectively manage nitrogen in hard red wheat, a crop that's usually grown in western provinces and imported into Ontario. Hooker believes that local growers could successfully produce hard red wheat if they apply nitrogen specifically to increase yields and protein content. If he and his research team are successful, this could mean a $65 million a year hard red wheat industry for Ontario.
Professor Hooker describes some of the challenges facing Ontario's hard red wheat industry today.
Inconsistent protein levels and also the quality of protein might not be as good as what the millers require. So if the millers don't get the hard red wheat that they want from Ontario, they'll just get it from western provinces.
Nitrogen contributes to the protein in wheat flour, which allows bread to rise evenly. It's also a very expensive nutrient that can account for between 20% to 40% of a producer's costs. Hooker and his team grew wheat at 35 sites across southern Ontario. They found a huge variability in the response to nitrogen between fields, with many requiring levels significantly higher or lower than the previously advised norms. Hooker believes nitrogen mismanagement could cost producers as much as $100 an acre.
The costs are great if we underapply, because if we underapply, that means we might reduce the protein levels, we might reduce yield drastically, we might reduce profitability. If we overapply, that means the wheat plant or the plants don't take up the nitrogen, so then it's susceptible to being lost to the environment. The trick is to try and figure out ahead of time, before we apply it, which fields respond and which don't.
To help guide producers with the individual nitrogen needs of their fields, Hooker is looking to develop an online informational tool, similar to the one used for corn, which takes factors like yield and price into account to provide specific recommendations for nitrogen use.
So we've developed a wheat nitrogen calculator from a database of about 30 years of data, nitrogen data from across Ontario. So we just need to do some number crunching to develop some of these relationships, and then we'll have a field-specific wheat nitrogen calculator.
He's also tailoring a device known as the Green Seeker for use in wheat fields. It identifies the amount of nitrogen in the soil and plants using infrared technology and could provide specific nitrogen profiles for a field. Excess runoff of unabsorbed nitrogen can contaminate nearby water sources, affecting local aquatic life and potentially polluting drinking water. That means responsible management of nitrogen is a concern for everyone.
So we're doing everything that we can to fine-tune the nitrogen rates, to reduce the sources of pollution in the environment, and to also increase the profitability on the farm.
If producers can successfully grow hard red wheat in Ontario, they'll harvest more than just a nutritious food source. The economy, environment, and people of this province will all share in the bounty of this valuable crop. For Spark Air, I'm Natalie Osborne.